Well, he is not backing down. Instead, Rudy Giuliani is doubling down.
Yeah, going on Fox News to say President Trump did not break any campaign finance laws by reimbursing a payment to Stormy Daniels.
Did you misspeak or did people not interpret what you were saying? Were you talking about the facts or were you talking about the law, Mr.
Mayor? I'm talking about the law and the conclusion. The facts, I'm still learning. I'm not an expert on the facts yet. I'm getting there. But I am an expert on the law, and particularly the campaign finance law. I've lived under it running for president. And the fact is, there is no way this is a campaign finance violation of any kind, nor was it a loan. It was an expenditure. And this expenditure would have been made whether he was running for president or he wasn't running for president.
So hours later, live from New York, Stormy Daniels, kind of going after the president there. The adult film actress shows up on Saturday Night Live, tells Alec Baldwin's Trump that she will not stop until he resigns.
Now, back in the real White House drama, the drama we know continues. You heard Giuliani say that on Fox News there, he's an expert on campaign finance law. Well, that did not stop him from talking about the other burning question for the White House this week, what to do on the Iran deal.
Here he is at the Iran Freedom Convention. Listen to this.
We've got a president who's tough, a president who doesn't listen to the people who are naysayers, and a president that is as committed to regime change as we are. And with Secretary of State Pompeo now on his right hand and his national security advisor, John Bolton, you remember John Bolton, on his left side, what do you think is going to happen to that agreement, that nuclear agreement?
All righty, joining us live from Washington, Sarah Westwood, CNN White House reporter. Hi, Sarah. How are you?
Hi, Christy.
Okay,
good morning.
So what is your take on everything that we're seeing here? It sounded like Rudy Giuliani sounded an awful lot like President Trump, let's put it that way, when we heard from President Trump on Friday.
That's right. And Rudy Giuliani has spent the past few days clarifying the bombshell comments that he made Wednesday night on Fox about Trump's reimbursement to his lawyer, Michael Cohen, for the payoff Cohen gave to adult film actress Stormy Daniels just before the 2016 election in exchange for her silence about an alleged affair. Now, Giuliani's frequent public statements has been causing headaches inside the White House at a time when the president is preparing to face down a number of consequential foreign policy issues, including the deadline this week to decide on the Iran nuclear deal. Now, as we just saw, Giuliani went farther than anyone else in the administration has gone so far in predicting what the president will do with the Iran nuclear deal. And later, he had this to say as he cleaned up those remarks.
I mean, it's a different thing when he's president of the United States, and I don't mix my role as an attorney for him with my foreign policy views. You know what my desire is, but I can't give you a prediction because I represent the president, and I certainly can't speak for him. Bolton maybe or Pompeo can speak for him, but I can't.
Now, sources tell CNN that Giuliani has not been consulting with senior staffers before making these public statements about the president's legal predicament. And now Giuliani's wading into the foreign policy territory. It may escalate tensions even further between Giuliani and the rest of the White House, Christy.
All righty, we'll be watching. Of course, Sarah Westwood, good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, joining me now, Daniel Lipman, reporter and co-author of the Politico Playbook, and Kelly Jane Torrance, deputy managing editor at the Weekly Standard. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
All right, so Kelly Jane, let's start here with what is Rudy Giuliani's job description? He's opining on the future of the Iran deal. He, on Thursday, said that the detainees in North Korea would be released later in the day. They weren't. He's also going out and, of course, defending the president on this Stormy Daniels situation. He's all over the map, it appears.
No, he is. And I have to say, I think, Victor, that Rudy Giuliani might have the hardest job in Washington, except maybe for the president. But by the way, I was at the conference that he spoke at yesterday, and I chatted with him afterwards as well. And he actually brought up North Korea, the three Americans imprisoned in North Korea, and he brought it up again yesterday. And he said, straight up, they are going to be released very soon because of President Trump. But yeah, what is his job description? It's a good question. And, you know, I think that the president has really, you know, despite the fact that we're, you know, President Trump has attacked Robert Mueller and others on Twitter, he has basically been reactive. He is, you know, giving his comments on defense. And I think with Rudy Giuliani, he is going on offense. And Giuliani, no, he's not talking to other staffers. He's going out. And let's face it, if he wasn't supposed to be doing this, he would probably be criticized by his boss on Twitter. And he's not. And, you know, I chatted with Rudy yesterday, and he was in great spirits, great form. He did not sound like someone who had been dressed down by the president for his bold statements.